Alright guys, we're going to take a stab at those front wheels. And you know I cleaned them up a little bit on that detail. That's not a scratch. Comes right off my finger. Sweet. Yeah, these wheels are in pretty good condition. Maybe you can see a lot of like deep stain there, which will come off with the right amount of scrubbing. But there's stains right here. I don't know. Let me show you. I don't know if you can pick it up in that far away angle. But this is like break. Let me see if I can get the right angle on you. You can see that, right? Yeah. That's like stain. And there was tons more of that when I got my new pads and when I did my cleaning. And I got most of it off. I thought I got all of it off, but obviously I didn't. So first thing, I'm gonna go ahead and give it a nice mellow spray. I guess I am going to attempt a ceramic on these wheels. It looks super tricky. I don't know. Every curve and everything. I could probably do it. If I did the whole car, I could figure it out. Just ceramic the whole thing, every nook and cranny, and the back. So first I'm going to take my Detail Pro degreaser. Go to detailpro.com. Remember, you have a coupon code, LastHumansGarage. I think it's 10% or something. So you find a good price there, throw in the code, you have an even better price, all right? And don't forget, Detail Pro Ceramic is only 50 before my coupon. You can get it for like, I don't know, 45 or something ridiculous like that. For a ceramic, they'll do your car, most cars, at least two times, plus the accessories, you know, the glass and all that. So I'm using degreaser. Now I don't want to let this sit too long on this wheel, you know? It's not the best thing for the wheels. This is not gonna work good. Let me find some better supplies. Well, I'm just gonna go with some Maxi suds with a regular hose, not a pressure washer. I'm gonna start with that, just a regular mitt. And yeah, it's like 77, no, probably 75 already. It's gonna be another hot one. And I'm just gonna do my first scrub. Now, I don't even know if this will be enough to get off. Ooh, you know, that's cool. I can feel those stains with my thumb, you know, that we talked about. It's thick, you can tell. And I just feel it get smoother and smoother until I knock it off, and then it's super smooth and slippery. So I think really this might be a little bit harsh for the wheels, degreaser, and not really necessary, to be honest. I'm no professional. I'm just giving my thoughts on how you guys would probably think, just sitting at home going, what should I do? I think some soap will work fine, and my mitt is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm gonna finger these holes right here. Barrels. The barrels are these things. Okay. All right. I don't feel any more rough spots where it doesn't rub smooth. So I think I got all the last bit of caked on brake dust off that I missed last time, right? I'll let that soap sit for a minute. Now, I put the mitt back in the bucket, and a lot of you guys will say, that's not how you do it, dude. What the hell are you doing putting a dirty mitt back in the bucket? Yeah, I know. See, I know the right way to do things. It just doesn't mean I'm going to do them, or it doesn't mean I'm that obsessed to do them, but I know I should have two buckets. That's obvious. When I get real dirt, like at least better than nothing, I'll squeeze the dirt out a bit before I put it back in. You know, better than nothing. If I'm not gonna use two buckets, at least don't put a big squirty pile of dirt back in there, right? And I've already done these barrels a little bit, so they're not too bad. Just redoing all the spokes, the barrels of ecstasy. Damn, this is a big barrel. I mean, to me, this is freaking ready to ceramic after I wipe this off. I think this should be good. Get out some of that brown soap. All of it, pretty much. Then go into the fresh and let it sit. All right. Am I still recording? Yeah, I am. Now we'll do some rinse off. I didn't like do the tires yet. I'll probably do a little of that too. A brush style, I mean. I haven't really done any work on the tires yet. It's like a preliminary. Look at that. I got a little chip or scratch right there on the inside of the wheel. Only something an obsessed person would worry about. I'll probably do I'm probably gonna hit this with clay too on the inside. I don't know about the outside, is pretty smooth, but the inside barrel, I could use a little clay. I felt a few bits of embedded dirt. All right, that's the first step. Let me go get some more stuff. All right, so I'm just gonna take some Detail Pro detailing spray and a Mother's Quick Clay, or Clay Quick, or whatever the hell it's called. Ow, stones on my knees don't feel good. There we go. Ow, my knees are digging into stones. Nice and detailed sprayed up. Oh, Quick Clay or something, whatever it's called. Which I don't like, by the way. Ow, did I mention I have a tub of Griot's clay coming today, old style clay. No reason for Griot's except that it was just the one that looked good on the Amazon. Some clay that I'm familiar with, I like better. Oh, that's the printing on it. That's why it's weird sounding. Can't scrub that off. I mean, that's good. Use the point of the clay here just to get every little bit except that big silver scratch. Okay. That's pretty much clayed. That's all there is to it. Now, in a rare case where I don't use Detail Pro, I have some of this stuff, but it's almost gone, so I'm going to use this 3M wheel cleaner instead. Wheel and tire cleaner. For my tires next. I might as well do my tires while I have good access to them. So let me start with a non-abrasive wipe brush, which will be fine. Don't want to go with the brass brush. You're going to be scratching up your rubber a little bit. This is nice and stiff. Wow. I thought these tires were clean. And this is turning brown. Wow. Definitely has me wanting to do the fronts next and see if I can get anything off them. I mean, I never clean the backsides, so it's not surprising, but I just cleaned the fronts, you know, half-ass. It'll be interesting to see if I can scrub some dirt out of the fronts. I'm sure I can. Beautiful. That used to be white. Just look at that. All right, not white, but yellowish. Pretty dirty. Oh, this wheel's like 100 pounds. Exaggerating a little. Let's see. All right, I'm gonna do these front tires too. I'll use the 3M tire cleaner. I hardly ever use 3M tire cleaner. What I love is 3M tire restorer. That's the only tire dressing I'll use myself. I know everybody has their favorite one. That's my favorite one. 3M tire restorer. Almost no gloss, super easy. When I tried that, I never tried anything else after that. That's my thing, 3M restorer. see, not too much dirt at all, as I was talking about. I did already clean these, not with a brush, mind you, with a frickin' sponge, but they just don't get that dirty. Let me go in all the crevices to make sure, in the lines. No, this isn't getting too dirty at all, guys. Oh, I'm spraying tire dirt on my skin. Not too bad at all. Alright, well, I think it's time for like a dry or something. I may take a little polisher to these things. A rupees maybe. A little bit. I can't polish this, man. This is like, I don't have the tools, you know, to polish something like this correctly. I don't have a 2-inch disc. Not to mention how impossible it would be. So I could hand polish it, you know, the old way, the way that nobody does anymore. I'll take my hand and polish this, hopefully find a new foam pad somewhere. And not that you're not gonna really cut anything with your hand, it's not gonna polish that well, but better than nothing. But I do need to dry this off now, next phase, dry it off on the bench. You know what I just found out recently? You know, my Detail Pro shirt? That, I don't know what that is. Chevy, I'm not a Chevy. It looks like a Chevy maybe, or a G, no. Oh, duh, it says it right there, a GTX. That car in the picture is the president of Detail Pro's dad's car, I believe. I just read some posts on that a few minutes ago. And I think they're talking about Papa's car on the shirt, so that's pretty cool right there, huh? All right, let me get you some top look here. I'm gonna use two pluffles. I believe these are Rag Company pluffles. I know I shouldn't do it on tire, but I just cleaned it, whatever. It's pretty clean. Just a light bit. Look at that dirt still, see? So I use the other, and I'm gonna, of course, turn the rag a few times. I'm gonna start drying these things off with a pluffle, which would probably soak up this entire, all this water just in one. And I got two for each wheel, see that? This cart's a little bit sketchy, but as long as I'm careful and I don't pull the wheel off it. So you have, see like right, you can't see it. A little bit of stain right there. See that actually didn't come off? Now I can, not that I should, but I can put extra pressure and just clean it and be done with it. But a professional detailer would probably get out some more product and like melt it away and shit, like stuff like that. I'm gonna use a little product, so I'm not rubbing pure dry rag on this thing, but there's a few spots I do want to touch up. See that right there? There's a few little marks here and there which need a little touching up, so let me work on that. All right, we are gonna take a little rupees to it, or this will take me forever to get off those stains. And you can see I'm using a very unusual method. There's like, you can't smear that on a nice flat body panel, so I'm doing the smearing with my hand first. That's plenty, that's like 4 or 5 big drops all rubbed in. So it's already kind of pre-mixed. Now I do need to heat it up a little bit, you know, try and get you an angle there as best as possible. And be very careful. Now you do have a nice big wide bit here. I'm gonna try not to scratch anything. I'll go with like a 4. I'll get it warm for a minute, remember that? Really let it warm up. Interesting. Going from 4 to 6 speed like doesn't make any audible difference barely. I'm at 6 now. And of course, I'm not going to get all the crevices. I'm pretty much getting the surfaces, which is where the stains are anyway. This is rupees on full power, guys. It doesn't sound like it, does it? That's how smooth it is. we go. It wasn't oscillating. I think I was pressing too hard. Pattern. I'm going everywhere. I'll go around the circle. Kind of angling it up. See that? I'm using like edge a little bit without pushing too hard. Instead of flat. Wheels are kind of hard. I should definitely have a smaller pad, but you know. Oh, good. I just saw it wipe away a stain right there with the nice polish action. This does get up the stains, the brake stains, pretty good. Whether or not this is the right way to get up those stains, I don't know. Going around again, why the hell not? As I go around and dry it, I see more little stain shadows, and I go back to them. And this pad's way too big for this. You don't need to tell me that. I wouldn't mind a smaller rupee, but yeah, these are expensive. Longer than I rupeed my tank. Oh, man. Another sweet best thing about the rupees is the flat part you can lay against, so it's not going to flop over like all your other, you know, all your other polishers. Let me show you. It doesn't fall over on its side like the other ones. It's a little bit dirty, not too bad. So I did actually decide to buy the rupees. And again, I can't tell you the price, but I made my first payment of two on it. I didn't have to, but I'm trying to be careful with my money and stuff, and Ryan has no problem with that whatsoever. So I did make my first one of two payments on the rupees. I guess it's my polisher, not yet, until I make that last payment. So I am the proud owner of a Rupees 15. Now I want to buy a Rupees small one. I wonder if it's cheaper for stuff like this. As you just saw, I had to freaking do a wheel with a 5.5-inch Rupees pad, which was ridiculous. All right, the polish is setting up nice. I'm gonna go ahead and get one of my brand new Korean Eagle edgeless rags and start polishing this up, wiping it off. The rag company, Eagle Edgeless 500s, super good. I was gonna save these for my paint as they're so good, but I guess I'll sacrifice one for the wheels. And I'll probably use just this one for all four wheels. I mean, oh wow. I'll try and get you a light. Oh my God, these things haven't shown like that ever. Oh, sweet. Oh my God. Awesome. Oh my God. I wasn't expecting this good of a result, guys. I've just wiped the center, but I mean, look at just the center. Wow. Oh my God. We haven't even done ceramic yet. Oh, I'm psyched about this. I'm gonna turn camera off and enjoy myself wiping the rest of this polish off. I'll be right back. Yeah, that big old honking 5.5 is not very good. Oh, look how clean that gets, though. It's not very good for tiny wheel access, obviously. So someday, in a perfect world, I'd like to get an even better Rupas for small places. I mean, this will work for now, but it's definitely not the best job I could do with these tools. Man, I'm gonna need like two hands to really get this thing going. I'll be right back. Alright, I took a second pass with the polisher. It just wasn't coming up nice, you know. It wasn't getting much, it was still super dull. So that's a second pass. And now I wiped a little off. You can see it's getting a little bit better. It's getting a little shine to it. But yeah, the wheel barrels take a lot of work to really get them right. So I'm just gonna probably have to do a bit more. All right, guys, a little change of plans. I'm not gonna ceramic these right now because that would be sealing this all in. It's not perfect yet, but I mean, I've spent a long time on it. I need, you know, better tools. Now you see, I do have a 3-inch Porter cable, and I shouldn't put that there. And I'm gonna go ahead with some Detail Pro poly sealant on this puppy. I don't want to ceramic yet and make it permanent because I'm gonna just have to rethink it. Maybe I just need to spend hours on one barrel, but it doesn't. I must, you know, something's not right. It shouldn't take me hours to just get one barrel clear. Now I could probably use some cutting compounds or something like that. But for now, I did like 3 or 4 passes of the Rupas on this barrel. It used to be dull. Now it has a light sheen to it a little bit. But I'm gonna go ahead and just wax it up for now. Poly sealant it up instead of locking in all that stuff that I might want to get out later, you know, just a little bit of safety. This thing is like rough compared to the other one. I'm gonna do this on about 4. This is probably gonna feel like crap. Problem I've had with these, when I put any kind of pressure on it, it stops spinning. I don't get it. Am I supposed to go so light that it spins, but then I'm not putting any pressure on it? Is it doing anything? Or put pressure on it, stop it from spinning, but at least it has pressure. That's always been a confusing one for me. It's spinning now, but I'm barely, like, pressing on it, you know? See? If I press, it stops spinning. Pressure and stop. What's the trick on that? All right. The Porter actually stands on its end, but it's very unstable. If I just bump it, it would fall on its side and the pad would go in the dirt. Yeah, if you heard all that, I don't know, like, I have to go super light. Feels like I'm not doing anything for it to continue spinning. As soon as I put a little pressure on it to feel like I'm going to cut into it, it stops spinning. You can't win either way. What's the trick on that? Poly sealant. It's not the best thing in the world, but I mean, 10 times better than it was. It was covered in dirt and stains. So, not bad. I've seen a lot of lint out of this Eagle thing today, which is disappointing. Are you not supposed to wash them first, or are you? Maybe that's my mistake. I've been getting a lot of lint flecks out of this thing. But that's it. I'd say the bottom is done for my standards, which aren't very high. And I'm gonna flip it over, do the same thing to the front face as best I can, wipe it down and be done. This has been over an hour on one wheel. That's probably standard, but I'm not even gonna do the ceramic. All right, guys, the difference is insane, so I wanted to show you. Let me try and, you know, I like to stop the GoPro and it lets the colors just soak in. Look at the one on the left that's done and its shine against the one I haven't touched yet. It's dull. It isn't even shiny. Now look at the one I did. Very different. I mean, I'm definitely happy with this. I did want a ceramic, to be honest, but now's just not the right time until I get the right tools. Not touched wheel, full of dirt. Nasty. And for me, perfection.